In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. My dear brother and sister, fraternal greetings to you from the Carmelite Fathers, and warm welcome to Carmel Light, reflection on the day's readings. It's the 26th of October and Saturday of the 29th week in ordinary time. The Holy Gospel according to Luke chapter 13 verses from 1 to 9. There was some present at that very time who told Jesus of the Galileans whose blood Pilate had mingled with their sacrifices. And he answered them, "Do you think that these Galileans were worse sinners than all the other Galileans because they suffered thus? I tell you, no. But unless you repent, you will all likewise perish." Or those 18 upon whom the tower in Siloam fell and killed them, do you think that they were worse offenders than all the others who dwelt in Jerusalem? I tell you, no. But unless you repent, you will all likewise perish. And he told this a parable. A man had a fig tree planted in his vineyard, and he came seeking fruit on it and found none. And he said to the vine dresser, "Behold, these 3 years I have come seeking fruit on this fig tree, and I find none. Cut it down. Why should it use up the ground?" And he answered him, "Let it alone, sir, this year also, till I dig about it and put on manure. And if it bears fruit next year, well and good. But if not, you can cut it down." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. In our daily situation, my dear friends, when we come across some incidents that are sad and painful, we have the tendency to speak about it or share with one another and ask the question to ourselves, why this suffering? Why this suffering? We hear something similar in the Gospel of today. Some people who are with Jesus hear about Herod's licentious killing of Galileans. Then Jesus himself refers to 18 who died when the tower of Siloam fell on them. Apparently, they were innocent victims of a calamity which was due to no fault of those killed. Those making the report were looking for Jesus to offer some explanation of why bad things happen to good people. Why bad things happen to good people. The sin and calamity issue involves a presumption that an extraordinary tragedy in some way must signify extraordinary guilt. It assumes that a victim must have done something terrible for God to allow something so tragic to happen to them. Jesus' answers to this presumption is a very clear no. Jesus' answer to this presumption is a very clear no. Today we might still have vestige of that old thinking. When something goes wrong, we may be saying, "What did I do to deserve this?" Well, sometimes it may be true. But in the biblical sense, there are times I did not do anything to deserve it. It's not likely God's retribution for an uncharitable act some time ago. In some essence, he's saying, just because you escaped some misfortune that befell your neighbor doesn't mean that in God's eyes you are the better person. And just because sorrow has visited your life doesn't mean that you are lesser in God's eyes. It's a difficult message for rational men to understand. According to Jesus, we should learn from things happening around us and in our lives. Repent and allow God to enter our lives in order to bear abundant fruit. Repent and allow God to enter our lives in order to bear abundant fruit. Let us pray. Zeus Rocco Norona from Kuwait, Glanson D'Souza from Gurupur, Ajit Joshua Norona from Udupi, Amanda Mascarenhas from Melbourne, Viola Lauren Martis from Shankarpur are celebrating their birthday today. We wish them happy birthday and we pray God's choicest blessings on them. Wilson Roshan and Crystal Martina DiMello from Belmont are celebrating their wedding anniversary today. We congratulate them and also we pray for their intentions. And in the moment of silence, we remember our own personal intentions and ask the intercession of Our Lady of Mount Carmel as we pray the novena prayer. Holy Mother of God, we greet you as Queen and Mother of Carmel. You were raised from being a lowly handmaid to the great dignity of Mother of the Word Incarnate. We dedicate ourselves as an act of filial homage. We glorify the Holy Trinity by honoring you, and in our many needs, we have recourse to your protection and your powerful intercession. Jesus, your Son, was so obedient to you on earth, will certainly grant your petitions on our behalf. With this trust and unbounded confidence, we beseech you to hear our prayers and obtain for us of your divine Son the favors we request in this novena, having experienced the efficacy of your prayers, we are full of confidence that you will gain for us this favor, if it is for the glory of God and for our good. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Our Lady of Mount Carmel, pray for us. Thanksgiving prayer. Holy Mother of God and Queen of Carmel, we, your children, come before you in a spirit of filial devotion and gratitude. As mother of our spiritual life, you have obtained for us innumerable graces and blessings from our Heavenly Father, who has given to us through you the greatest of all treasures, Christ our Lord. We recognize with deep sentiments of thankfulness all the spiritual favors that have come to us through your powerful intercession. And in particular, we thank you for your special protection over those who wear your holy scapular with faith and love. And finally, we thank you for answering our prayers in our personal needs. We implore from you the great grace of final perseverance, that we remain faithful to the end to your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, who is Lord forever and ever. Amen. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Have a great weekend. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.